Welcome back, students, with today's topic. And today we are going to talk about important themes and novel hard times, right? As you know that constantly we are dealing with this particular novel, that is hard times. Today we are going to look at it from the point of view of several themes, right? From the point of view of the several critics as well, their commentary and the important dialogues that are actually related to these particular themes, right? Themes, as we know, that theme is something that is related to the central idea, main crux, or we can say that the main lesson behind writing a particular thing, writing a particular work of art or something like that, right? So as we know that everything is based on a particular sort of theme. Everything that is written for a purpose, the main purpose behind it is to educate others, to actually give the moral lesson with the help of that piece of art, right? So same is the case with this novel as well. It portrays number of themes, and out of those number of themes, I have selected only three themes, that is related to industrialism, femininity, and fact versus vanity, fancy, right? So you'll see that these are the major themes that this novel actually talks about. So let us talk about one by one in detail all these themes, right? So the first important theme is fact versus fancy. As we know that this novel actually propagates the things that are related to fact, and there is a sort of clash between, there is a sort of conflict between these two ideas. One is fact and second is fancy. So Dickens depicts a terrifying system of education where facts are pounded into the school children all day, and where memorization of information is valued over art, imagination, or anything creative, right? So as we know that Dickens has portrayed such sort of schooling system, education system, that where only facts are actually propagated, facts are only given to the students, school children, all the day. Pounded is actually a word that we usually use for the sound that is actually constantly comes in your mind, or we can say that propagated in your mind, right? Then, and where memorization of information is valued over art. So everything that was important was art. Facts and imagination, art, or anything that is related to creativity or that is creative was not allowed at that very moment, at that very situation. So this results in some very rapt human beings. So that's the scene, that's the scenario, that's the context, that's the reason that all the characters, you'll see that Dickens has portrayed, the human beings that Dickens has portrayed, they have got the quality that is actually rapping sort of quality. Rapping is, you know, that thing that is completely, we can say that is wrapped, or we can say that tempered sort of human beings, in short. So examples here are with us, first of all, Mr. Gradgrind. He was okay. I have taken the words from these words, these inverted commas. The words in the inverted commas are actually the words from Dickens, right? He says that Mr. Gradgrind was a man of realities, a man of facts and calculations, a man who proceeds upon the principle that 2 and 2 are 4 and nothing over. So this was the basic principle of that man, and he was actually the man of facts, the man of realities, and the man of calculations, nothing more than that. So he believes completely in this system, and as a superintendent of school and a father, he makes sure that all the children at the schools he's responsible for, especially his own children, are brought up knowing nothing but data and ologies, right? As you know, as he was a man of facts, man of realities, man of calculations, he was not only a father, but as we know that he was running an institution or education system or a school. So he was serving over there as a superintendent as well. So you will see that he was in charge of the school as well. So he was actually responsible propagating them or brought up them in such a situation where nothing but they should study data ontologies. Data, we mean data as you know that the body of information, right? And ologies, we mean the study of something. So whenever you are going to study something, for that we use the term ologies, right? So he only propagates facts as a study to them, thus to them, and reality, nothing more than that. So again, here are the words. These are the actually this is actually the opening line of the novel, in which the situation is this, that Gradgrind was actually was in a classroom, and over there he was just focusing on this word, that now what I want is facts. Facts alone are wanted in life. So this is the quotation from Mr. Gradgrind, and he was just talking about facts, facts, and facts. That's the scene, and that was the actually the real purpose, or we can say that the only purpose of that man, to teach or to give the information of nothing more than that of facts, right? So similarly, if we further talk about this fact and fantasy, that the theme that we are talking about that appears in this novel, right? As a result, things go very badly for his children, Tom and Louisa, right? So since they, as the children, are always treated as if they had minds and no hearts, their adulthoods are wrapped as they have no way to access their feelings or connect with others. Okay, as we know that the children, or we can say that other students that he was actually bringing them up, was nothing more than that of wrapped sort of, or we can say that pampered sort of generation it was. So you'll see that they are always treated as if they had minds only. By mind, we mean that they are the actually believers of the realities and facts. So there is no heart in their actually in their lives. There is no importance of feelings. There is no importance of, we can say that, emotions, etc. So as they have no way to access their feelings or connect with others, that's the scene that they are wrapped sort of, pampered sort of kids or children. Then Tom is a sulky person. Sulky person, we can say that we use the term, as we know that yesterday we have talked about the character of Tom, right? You'll see that he was very much like a pessimistic sort of candidate, and he gets involved in an effort to pay off gambling debts. And Louisa was also unhappy. If you look at her character, she was unhappy too when she follows her mind, not her heart, and marries Mr. Bounderby, who was actually double in her age, right? Then Mr. Gradgrind says that okay, this is the situation where Mr. Gradgrind utters this dialogue. He says that the moment Mr. Bounderby offers Louisa for proposal, right? Over there, Mr. Gradgrind says to Louisa that love, he declares to be in this context irrelevant, and calls it a misplaced expression. So this sentence, this phrase actually gives the full-fledged sort of idea that this man, Mr. Gradgrind, was the only believer of rationalism, or we can say that realities and facts, nothing more than that. So this was the only concern of that man. That's why, and this is how he has ruined the life of not only his kids, Tom and Louisa, but the other children to whom he was actually educating.